All right, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Horizon Forbidden West. I am Captain Beefy here with the Game Vault. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Ring that bell for notifications. Also, don't forget to leave a comment on the video and a like down below. It is appreciated, especially when you share us on social media. So we... I'm going to go face that damn turtle, that shell snapper again, see if we can't take him out. He gave us a run for our money a few episodes back, but I do want to complete this contract with the salvage people, so... You know, it's kind of important. So I understand if I get all of those contracts done, I think we're up for like a really nice set of armor or something along those lines. So that's kind of cool. But first, let's take a moment and just admire this. Look when she runs through the sand. You have footprints, and they don't immediately fade like they do in a lot of games, you know? How long they'll sit there for. Looks like they're staying for a while. I wonder if they stay until like a storm blows through or something. That'd be kind of interesting. But anyways, that just gives you a idea of the level of detail they do in this game. I believe they do that also for the snow. Well, in fact, I'm sure of it. So I see that shell snapper over there. We're kind of aggressively sneaking up on him.
Must have been right through that metal.
Let's get everything marked. Alright, so fire. Acid are the ways to go. Looks like we got a storm coming our way. I don't know how that's going to affect things.
Is that a machine? Or a walking fortress? I have to be careful with my
hair. These things are awful. So, we've got advanced blast traps. We've got 9 of them. I think last time we had 4. Did quite a significant amount of damage, so the trick is going to be to stay out of his range, his sight, so that we can drop these down and do some serious damage to him, you know. So that's going to be the trick. I'm kind of debating, like, do I put a bunch of them together and try to wipe them out one shot? What do I do? Things are really good too. Alright. What are you doing, buddy? Looking my way. I know it. I know it. You're a total jerk. Alright, he's taking off. So if I drop.
Shoot.
see me already. I was just a nice little hiding spot there. Alright. Nothing to see up here. Alright, he's being really annoying.
You're on guard for now.
Spike. Did a moderate amount of damage, so nothing special. Spikes are pretty good.
Azadan will make this go quick.
Alright, so he's gonna go all the way up there. Right? Yeah. So I'm thinking maybe I should go down. Spot to hide. We can go ahead and drop a trap.
It's here.
Drop one here. All right, so we can only get two out at once. That's fine. Get ourselves situated. Ready to go about this business. The This is just going to require patience at this point. I'm really not sure how else to handle this guy right now because he's such a jerk. So let's let him march. So we wait. While we wait, we have two more. That's all we can make. Alright. So for now we're done. Let's let him go. I think with the little bit of damage he's already sustained.
Plasma's wasted against that machine.
Four of those traps will probably do him in. So we're gonna have to find out. I think there's still one other trap which will do some good damage to him. Spot where this guy always spawns. If it's here, then it's here. And I'm going to try to find some ways to maybe take him out a little more efficiently. Alright, good. He's on his route. That means he's coming up to the other one. Two more traps laid out. I think that blew up the other one.
I'm in close wars if I shoot that.
Let's see what happens here. Sorry about that. Off one of his frost blasters. I don't know if he's got two of them or not. I don't think he does he? Let's see. Plasma generator, magnetic dynamo, chill water sack, the sparkler. Oh, he does have another one. Okay. Alright, well, let's let him go on his walk. I'm pretty sure I got another bomb down the road there. Doing his complete walk. Let's see. We've got goodness. He's dead.
He should be able to get run to salvage now.
Let's dismantle that. Did he blow the other one? I think he did. Okay. Well, there's a trick.
I need to get the roller back salvage from the Shellsnapper. Might as well take the extra salvage to Runda.
Oh, yeah. Might as well indeed.
I can grab this from my stash later.
Alright, well, that was definitely a solid, attack on them. I guess I just need to be a little more aggressive. I really didn't think that was going to be the case, but it's good. We did all right. So where is... Oh, I didn't get the roller back salvage yet. So long I don't even remember what we're doing. That's not it either. Where is it? Peppers? Fine, I'll take the peppers. Where's the salvage? I want the salvage. I want to get out of here and get this contract over with.
Enough to forge some armor.
There we go.
Let me take it back to Rundle.
Perfect.
Purge water ammo could hurt us.
You come looking for me? That's what I thought. That's definitely what I thought. Now you're dead. Just trying to pick up a couple, little bit more scrap after what we used up in that turtle attack.
This wind's in a rush. Well, so am I.
Got them all jacked up on poison. Yeah, the desert's a little tougher than the woods, or the, yeah, that forested area that we started in. A lot less hiding places. You gotta kind of get yourself behind the dunes and gather. Flipping around, flanking them a little bit. He's toast.
somewhere.
That hurt. Gonna pick these guys apart right now, just kill them, gather up some goodies from them. Acid on me, but otherwise, cool. Life is good. Alright, let's see if there's anything else to loot out here, and then we're heading back, finishing off the salvage contract, because, yeah. That was fun. These bellow bags are nasty. They are some nasty-looking creatures. Just run around all polluted and full of poison.
Stuff for the stash.
Acid, or whatever you want to call it. They're gross. Gross, gross, gross. A thunder jaw up there. I honestly don't want to mix up with that right now. So we'll head over to this fire over here. 137, 108. Alright, we'll go to this one. Once we get there, we'll finish up that salvage contract. Yeah, so the Valor Surge with the notching of multiple arrows, that was those piercing ones, I believe, really inflicted some serious damage on that guy. I mean, we softened him up with a couple spear strikes, you know, with that exploding spear or whatever, that impact spear. And then I think he hit two bombs and a... acid from the dead bellow back on him too. So he was soft already, and boy, that double arrow strike with the Valor Surge was devastating.
You look like you've been in a fight.
let's talk.
Found your salvage. Had to find a Shellsnapper for it.
A Shellsnapper, huh? You know, after all this, I was thinking about making a new helmet for the armor.
Something
better prepared to deal with a sandstorm. That Shellsnapper salvage might do the trick. No sense in letting your hard work go to waste.
Glad it helped.
Here, your payment. Maybe when my armor wins Karev's competition, you'll come by to celebrate with us. If you have time to go back to Baron Light, that is.
Maybe so.
I'd like that. We'll see.
Alright, so 100 metal shards, sunshot hunter bow. Couple skill points. Let's take a look at that bow. Ooh. 44-146 on the tear. Yikes. That thing is devastating. So it is already better than my strong arm hunter bow. If I put a tear coil in it, 160. So what type of arrows does it use? Hold on. It's a hunter bow, so right? It uses just... Is that overdrawn? Quick Christmas. Yeah, I think that's overdrawn. So if we replace our strong arm hunter bow with it.
Man, this is a pretty good salvage out here.
We've got special arrows can designate a target for the overridden machines to attack. Oh, okay.
Okay.
That's kind of cool.
Get my tools ready. We're making some armor.
So we can hit something, and if we got creatures that are overridden in the area, so we can override a couple creatures, and then bam, hit a target with that, and they will attack it. And look at this. We have a bench over here. Let's see if we can upgrade this puppy right now. Because if we can, we're going to do it. And if we can, we're going to find the parts for it and do it, because that's kind of sick. So the Sunshot Hunter Bow. Now it gets 15% overdraw damage. Ah, a green shine fragment and a green shine cluster. This is 713 away, and the other is 208 away. Okay, well, let's try for the 208 first. Let's see what we can do here. So these are advanced hunting arrows. These are regular ones. These do 84, those do 168 in the tear. Oh my god. That's just sick. Take to make them 5 and 10. They're not cheap, but damn, they're gonna tear some stuff clean off in that creature. I think I see the green shine already. Yep. All right, so there's the fragment. Now the cluster. That's a different story. We're going to find that. That is not far from here. All right, so let's go back to the fire. Where is it? There it is. I love these little sand dunes, man. Those things are crazy looking.
I can get a first flash later.
Hop on this fire, fast travel over it, go get that. If it's not hidden behind something like a metal flower or something like that, which is my only concern. Pop off a quick save. Now we fast travel. Let's see what's happening with this. Says it's over here somewhere, right? Nope, it's over here. All right, it's in this area. I'm gonna have to find it. Amazing. All right, let's gather up some other goodies while we're here. I'm pretty sure we won't be able to upgrade it to the next level immediately afterward if we needed a cluster, and that's, I think, the first cluster I've come across. But hell, that's great. Here's another box. Let's take it. And another box. Let's take it. This was a lucrative little spot to get to. But this bow should make tearing up equipment very simple now. You know, taking components right off a creature should be nothing, especially after another upgrade. Oh my god, it's gonna be crazy. Alright, so let's just some peppers, okay. So where's a nearby workbench? I guess we could go into Plainsong. Where the hell's Plainsong? Oh, it's way over there. Okay. There's a fairly... Okay, that's that. We're here. Well, we could go back to our friends here. Let's do that. Let's go back to our buddies over here. Hang out in this area for a little bit.
It's good to see everyone's back to the usual selves.
Yeah, this is it. Okay. Because, yeah, we might even be able to upgrade it again afterward, depending on what it needs. We'll take a look and see. Well, it's going to open a new slot. Alright, so green shine chunk and two clusters. Oof. We got everything else, man. Alright, so let's go to that weapon. The hunting bow. Let's edit the coils and let us put in another tear. That's 6%. There's 6%. Let's do it. So now we're up to 187. We're doing overdraw damage, 15%. Draw speed's quicker. Corroding enemy damage is 10%. Next will be 15% aerial enemy damage. Yeah, this is pretty cool. All right, well, let's see where we have to go for these parts. 513 for a chunk. $51 for a cluster. Well, I guess we'll go for a chunk first.
Got some salvage.
Got a salvage you want to sell?
There's a chunk there, and it's in an area that we're not very familiar with. In fact, yeah, it's going to be a bit of a hike, so at this point...
There's another cauldron out there that has override data on that machine.
What's up, buddy? I guess it got triggered on a trap.
This will be in my stash when I need it.
Well, it's kind of badass. We just got to loot that guy for nothing, I guess. Yeah, I guess a trap went off and got him. Spikes now, it's whatever these things are. Let's get a look at it. One, two, three, another. So these guys are weak against fire and chill water. Strong against electric. They got acid canisters. Source containers, damage, dampener sack, amplifying sack, stamina drain sack. Ah, that's on the butt. Okay. So we definitely want to grab those big butt sacks. That sounds funny, right? Butt socks. All right, guys. Well, we're going to take these guys on in the next episode. So thanks for joining me for another episode of Horizon Forbidden West. I am Captain Beefy, as always, with the Game Vault. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and ring that bell for notifications. Also, don't forget to leave a like and a comment on the video. Let me know what you think of the series so far. I appreciate the feedback, and share us on social media. It is greatly appreciated when that's done. I'll see you next time.